Hi, this is Dr. B. Let's do the I3 minus Lewis structure. On the periodic table, iodine is in group 7, or 17. It has 7 valence electrons, but we have 3 of them. And then we have this negative up here, so we're going to add another electron to that. So 21 plus 1, 22 total valence electrons. So we'll put our iodines in lines, like this. And then we're going to put electrons between each of the atoms to form chemical bonds. Put a pair here, pair here, pair here, and now around atoms. So we've used 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. So we have 6 left over, and we'll just have to put them on the iodine right here, like this. So we've used all 22 of the valence electrons that we had available, and it's kind of a strange structure, so let's check our formal charges just to make sure that we have the best Lewis structure for I3-. So the two iodines on the outside, the ones in green, let's do those first. They're the same, so they'll have the same formal charge. On the periodic table, iodine's in group 7. It has 7 valence electrons. Non-bonding, these right here that are not involved in chemical bonds, we have 6. And then bonding, we have 2, but we'll divide that by 2. 7 minus 6 minus 1 gives us 0. For the iodine in the middle, the blue iodine, 7 valence electrons for iodine, we have 6 non-bonding. So these 4 up here aren't bonding, and these 2 down here. So 6 non-bonding valence electrons. And then we have 2 plus 2, 4 bonding valence electrons, which we'll divide by 2. 7 minus 6 minus 2 gives us a negative 1 charge. So all of this makes sense. We have the negative 1 charge here, but that makes sense. We have that negative there. So we can draw this with brackets so everyone can see that it is an ion. Put a negative up there. That's the Lewis structure for I3-. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.